Please get ready for transcription number 135. 5 seconds. Start. Now, sir, I know that this plan has just started and it is perhaps too early for us to say anything about it, but we have before us the experience of the 9 5-year plan. Sir, we had been told that due importance would be attached not merely in words but by practical steps to the public sector. I think in this connection it was the duty of the Honorable Minister to have explained to this House as to the steps that had been taken with a view to bringing about the kind of reorientation in favor of the public sector which was promised in his numerous statements. But I find that that is completely missing from his speech, except that a pious wish has been expressed with regard to this particular sector of our industry. Previously, we had under the purview of this act about 42 industries. Now the list has lengthened and a number of industries will be added. I concede that when we are having a planned economy, when we are thinking in terms of rapid development of industries, of rapid industrialization, it is necessary for the government to come into the picture more and more and assume the necessary control and direction of industries. I am not opposed to it at all. On the contrary, I would like them to vigorously act in this matter, but that is not enough. We must examine as to whether the direction, regulation, or whatever you call it is on the right lines, how it has worked. We have got such general statements from the ministers that they do not throw much light for us laymen on the matter. I wish that when such measures are brought before the House, a kind of white paper or whatever you call it is circulated among the members. You do not expect that we laymen in this House would easily understand these things until and unless we have some opportunities of studying the relevant data and the material on the subject. We have been denied those opportunities and I regret that we have been so denied. I know that in this respect, honorable members who come from big business or the business world would be in a somewhat advantageous position because they are familiar with the working of this act in a way which would enable them to speak more effectively. Now, Let us see how this has worked. I know that when this measure was first brought before the House several years ago, there was much opposition to it, which came not from the public but from certain business interests. They did not like any kind of government interference in industry. They believed in a kind of laissez-faire in this matter, and they thought that if the government came into the picture, their interests would suffer. Naturally, they were openly hostile to these kinds of powers for the government, but that was not the view of the country. I think that by and large, public opinion was in favor of government controlling industries, not the type of control that we had at the time of the World War II, but a type of control which sets before itself certain objectives, and as the objectives became clearer and clearer, as the government pronounced itself more and more in favor of industrialization in the country, public opinion strongly veered round that particular point of view of the government in this matter, viz. That government should have control over our industries. But it is the government which has not lived up to its promises. I think that in some respects they have let the people down, and the expectations of the people have been belied. Now take, for instance, the period between 1991, when the measure was first adopted, and now. What do we see? We do not have compact figures for the entire period. We have got only certain figures with regard to this matter. I would refer only to the progress reports on the 7th five-year plan. There you will see that the government had not taken any very effective steps for the development of the public sector. It is true that certain steel mills got going under the 7th five-year plan, and more will be started under the 8th plan. But if you look at the picture, you will find that the public sector was considered to be a secondary matter. It was the private sector which got all the attention and assistance of the government. I am not at all suggesting that government was totally unmindful of the public sector. What I am saying is that when the government entered into the picture, it did not give to the public sector the attention that it deserved. Stop.